Chapter 1. What is the social credit score system and its implications? Developed by the Government of the People's Republic of China, the social credit score system will rate you and either whitelist you or blacklist you as it functions as a digital reputation tracker. Yes, it's true. Every action you take, everything you say, and everywhere you travel, will be tracked and scored accordingly. Imagine everything you do, from buying groceries to jaywalking, being recorded and assigned a score. Your trustworthiness is assessed based on these scores, which can have real-world consequences. Think of it as a kind of personal report card that influences your access to loans, travel options, and many more things. In a nutshell, the social credit score system is an authoritarian's dream to digitally surveil the nation's citizens and control the masses according to their own wishes. As they say, it will bring national synchrony. If Hitler had thought to tighten his grip on the world like this, we would have believed it, and maybe that's why the Chinese Communist Party has been practicing it for years. But can a nation like the United States of America, a country of the most liberal people when it comes to thought, voice, and living, accept it? Americans will definitely raise their voices, right? Under the freedom of speech. But any monopolistic decision isn't integrated blatantly, it's nicely covered in the veil of promises, a promise of development, unity, and harmony. And then some become hostile to it, and some become used to it. But hold on a minute, what kind of restrictions are we really talking about? Well, if your score isn't up to par, you might find yourself denied access to high-speed trains or even flights. You can be restricted to an area, specific amenities, or a lavish lifestyle, and the extent of these constraints has not been put into words. Plus, every step against these regulations or the government itself can result in a low credit score. This system aims to keep citizens in check and encourage responsible behavior, but is it a step too far? Well, we feel like it's a relay race where you do have partners, but you're racing for your own sake. You have to make it count anyway. Chapter 2, A Glimpse into the Past. Let's take a trip down memory lane. To trace the origin of the social credit score system, we will have to rewind to the early 1990s, when the Chinese government was trying to develop personal banking and financial credit rating systems in China. It was an effort to make financial assessment easier in rural areas, where people and small businesses often lacked financial records. Soon after the Chinese economic reform in 1978, the whole society was swayed by clouds of mistrust and misconceptions, which gave birth to societal problems such as food safety scandals, labor law violations, intellectual property theft, and corruption. And that's when the governmental bodies drafted the initial blueprints of the social credit system in 2007 to bring moral values, ethical behavior, and rigid market supervision. Fast forward to the 2000s, and this concept evolved, drawing inspiration from credit scoring systems in other countries. It wasn't until 2011, during a state council meeting, that the system was formally introduced. Currently, the program is only active in China and a few other countries, but who knows how far it will extend. Chapter 3, Testing the Waters, City Trials and Experiments. So, did the government really put this system to the test? Certainly. In 2013, the Supreme People's Court, SPC, began creating a blacklist of debtors who became a precursor to the social credit system, which consisted of roughly 32,000 people. Then, in 2015, 8 companies got the green light to try out this new scoring system from the People's Bank of China. From Alibaba's Sesame Credit to ride-sharing giant Didi Chuxing, they all hopped on the bandwagon. Various companies collaborated with the government to develop the technical aspects of the social credit system, focusing on creating software and algorithms for credit scoring. These companies then conducted experimental programs that were authorized by the state, allowing them to test the system on a larger scale. Participants in these programs can enjoy the benefits of having good credit scores, and while the exact algorithms used are not fully disclosed, some pilots may involve advanced data analysis and AI methods. The basics say that the social credit score system isn't just about individuals, it's got its eyes on businesses, government institutions, and even non-government organizations. Managed by the National Development and Reform Commission and the People's Bank of China, its goal is to build trust in society and regulate various sectors, from food safety to financial fraud. But this credit system isn't all doom and gloom. Citizens with high scores get perks like easier access to credit loans and discounts. It's like turning good behavior into a rewards program and bad behavior into a crisis. Chapter 4, Who's Behind the Curtain? Meet the organization. So, who's pulling the strings behind this digital curtain? The social credit system is like a grand symphony conducted by the Central Comprehensively Deepening Reforms Commission. It's a coordinated effort that covers a wide range of companies, government organizations, individuals, and social organizations, except for those under the Chinese Communist Party. This system is diverse, with different branches focusing on businesses, government, society, and the judiciary. The Business Trustworthiness System, regulated by the People's Bank of China's Financial Credit Rating System and Commercial Credit Rating System, is a blacklist system for discredited business organizations. The Government Trustworthiness System is an evaluation system targeting civil servants and government institutions. The Social Trustworthiness System, related to China's mass surveillance systems, is a blacklist system for discredited individuals. The Judiciary's Public Trust System, regulated by Supreme People's Court, is a blacklist system for discredited individuals. Chapter 5, Misconceptions. Some rumors have been circulating about the social credit score system. So, let's put those misconceptions to rest and focus on the facts. First off, the social credit system isn't solely about individual citizens. Businesses are in the spotlight too. Plus, it's not some all-knowing AI making decisions. Human input and data collection play a big role. Thirdly, the system doesn't constantly monitor everyone. It's more like a periodic check-in. Chapter 6, Concluding Thoughts. So, what's the verdict on the social credit score system? While it's a bold attempt to foster trust and responsibility, it raises important questions about privacy and personal freedom. The system has come a long way since its origination, with city trials, pilot programs, and evolving mechanisms. As of now, it's still an ongoing experiment, with both successes and challenges. One thing's for sure, though, it's a topic that will keep us pondering and discussing for years to come.